Ackerman does and means for families is extraordinary. It's a place of healing where families in distress can work through issues and problems and really be heard in a deep and a profound way, and that's so important. Solving mental health problems and other relational dilemmas in the context of the family is what's unique about the Ackerman Institute approach. Many of these sessions with families from economically and socially marginalized communities, and no family is ever refused service because of an inability to pay. The repercussions of family issues, they echo well beyond the family circle, and we bring them with us into everything, into our relationships, into the school, the workplace, into every aspect of our lives. Strong families, of course, mean strong communities, and that's what Ackerman helps to create.
When you support the Ackerman Institute, you support the development of innovative strategies through clinical research for best practices. What actually works for families? Ackerman faculty members have been developing strategies for helping families with a whole host of issues. Feeling understood by your family is one of the greatest protections we can give our children to be able to live with strength in this world. With your help, we will continue to be there for all families that need us, and no matter how difficult the journey is, we'll stay with them every step of the way.
I am most appreciative to the Ackerman Institute for honoring me with the Distinguished Service Award. However, in reality, I should be honoring Ackerman for the quality and depth of their critical work with families. And I should be honoring Ackerman for the meaning, passion, and richness they have brought to my life.
I'm tremendously honored to be part of this. I'm a huge admirer of what Ackerman does. I look at the idea that in an era in which women are likely to work and men are likely to be more involved in childcare than their fathers were, that our ideas of motherhood and fatherhood are in some small measure at least beginning to merge toward an idea of parenthood, and to look at how that's both reflected in and occasioned by changed attitudes towards divorce, single parents by choice, or indeed not by choice, open adoptions, gay families, increased foster care, and all of the other new structures of the family, that family therapists are highly relevant to our day-to-day life.
We're very grateful for you being here tonight, and we look forward for everyone joining us again next year. Thank you very much.